In China, they say, the snake, knowing itself, strikes swiftly. It means that if you have confidence that what you are doing is part of your true nature, there should be no hesitation. I don't know whether your orders are in your true nature or not, but snake, believe in yourself.
Found the car key, right? First comes the room temperature key. Put it into the far left terminal in the control room. That key is actually an IC card. Its connector pins and main body are made of a shape memory alloy. It's designed so that unless it's been changed to the correct shape, it won't be recognized by the PAL code input terminal in the control room, and the detonation code won't be entered.
Thank you.
Next comes pal number three. Warm the key.
Snake, it's about Naomi Hunter.
Then you should talk to the Colonel. He's looking into it.
Turn your monitor off.
Okay, it's off. No one else can hear us. Go ahead.
Sorry, but I didn't want the Colonel to hear.
Okay, so what's up?
I've got a good friend in the Pentagon.
Yeah?
He's the one who told me about it. It looks like the DIA recently developed a new type of assassination weapon.
An assassination weapon?
Snake, have you ever heard of something called Fox Dye?
No. Fox Dye. Liquid and the others were talking about it.
Yeah. It's some kind of virus that targets specific people. I don't know all the details, but...
What are you trying to say?
It's too similar.
What is?
The cause of death. Didn't the arms tech president and the DARPA chief, Decoy Octopus, die of something that looked like a heart attack?
Yeah.
Well, a Apparently, Fox Dye kills its victims by simulating a heart attack.
No, you're telling me that Naomi was behind it?
Snake, try to remember. Did Naomi give you some kind of injection?
Nanomachines?
She was in the best position to have done it, but I don't know what her motive was.
Does the Colonel know?
I'm not sure, but he still hasn't questioned her.
Okay, I'll ask him myself. Colonel, what's new with the Naomi situation?
I just placed Naomi under arrest.
Arrest?
She was sending coded messages towards the Alaskan base. I didn't want to believe it, but she must be working with the terrorists.
Are you sure?
I'm afraid so. She's being interrogated now.
What kind of interrogation?
Well, I'd like to avoid the rough stuff, but we don't even have any sodium pentothal here.
Call me if you find out anything.
So it's true, isn't it?
Naomi, I can't believe it.
That means the Fox Dye vaccine must be around somewhere.
Listen, I've got bigger things to worry about.
But Snake, you might be infected too, you know?
All I can do is leave it up to the Colonel.
Thank you.
1965, and there were lots of Indian laborers around. That's probably where I got my skin color from, but I'm not even sure about that.
Naomi, you're too worried about the past. Isn't it enough to understand who you are now?
Understand who I am now? Why should I? No one else tries to understand me. I was alone for so long, until I met my big brother, and him.
Your big brother?
Yes. Frank Yeager.
What?
He was a young soldier when he picked me up near the Zambezi River. I was half dead from starvation, and he shared his rations with me. Yes, Frank Yeager. The man who you destroyed was my brother and my only family.
No. Grey Fox?
We survived that hell together, Frank and I. Protected me. It's my one connection. The only connection I have to my past.
And he brought you back to America?
No. I was in Mozambique when he came.
Who is he? You mean Big Boss?
Yes. He brought us to this land of freedom, this America. Then he and my brother went back to Africa to continue the war. That's when it happened. You killed my benefactor and sent my brother home a cripple. I vowed revenge and joined Foxhound. I knew it was my best chance to meet you, and I prayed for the day that I would.
So, were your prayers answered?
Yes. I waited 2 long years.
To kill me? Is that all you cared about?
Yes. That's right. 2 years. You were all I thought about for 2 long years. Like some kind of twisted obsession.
You still hate me?
exactly. I was partly wrong about you.
What about Liquid and the others?
I'll have my revenge on them too.
Naomi, you didn't kill that doctor too, did you? The one that used Gray Fox for his genome experiments?
Dr. Clark? No. That was my brother. Afterwards, I covered it up and helped him hide out.
So that ninja, I mean Gray Fox, he's come here to kill me?
I don't think so. I think he just came here to fight you. I wasn't sure before, but now I think I understand. A final battle with you, that's all he lives for. I'm sure of it.
Fox, no. Naomi, tell me something.
About Fox Dye? Fox Dye is a type of retrovirus that targets and kills only specific people. First, it infects the macrophages in the victim's body. Fox Dye contains smart enzymes created through protein engineering. They're programmed to respond to specific genetic patterns in the cells.
Those enzymes recognize the target's DNA?
Right. They respond by becoming active and using the macrophages, they begin creating TNF-epsilon. It's a type of cytokine, a peptide which causes cells to die. The TNF-epsilon is carried along the bloodstream to the heart, where they attach to the TNF receptors in the heart cells.
And then they cause a heart attack?
The heart cells suffer a shock and undergo an extreme apoptosis. Then the victim dies.
Apoptosis? You mean the heart cells commit suicide? Naomi.
What?
You must have programmed that thing to kill me too, right? Do I still have time? Naomi, I don't blame you for wanting me dead, but I can't go yet. I still have a job to do.
Listen, Snake. I'm not the one who made the decision to use Fox Dye.
Huh? You weren't?
No. You were injected with Fox Dye as part of this operation. I just wanted to let you know that. No, that's not the whole truth.
Huh?
The real thing I wanted to tell you was... Snake, I...
Hey, what are you doing?
Snake!
Naomi! Snake, I can't allow Naomi to make any more unauthorized transmissions.
What?
Naomi's been removed from this operation.
What happened to Naomi? What did she mean when she said that Fox Dye was a part of this operation? Colonel, let me talk to her.
I won't. She's under arrest.
Colonel, you double-crossed me.
Snake, there's no time for that. Right now, your job is to stop Metal Gear. Okay, Snake?
Thank you. Too. I really must express my gratitude.
Sorry to have involved you in that silly shape memory alloy business.
What are you talking about?
We weren't able to learn the DARPA chief's code. Even with Mantis' psychic powers, he couldn't read his mind. Then Ocelot accidentally killed him during the interrogation. In other words, we weren't able to launch the nuclear device, and we were all getting a little worried. Without the threat of a nuclear strike, our demands would never be met.
What do you mean?
Without the detonation codes, we had to find some other way. That's when we decided you might prove useful, Snake.
What?
First, I thought we might get the information from you, Snake. So I had Decoy Octopus disguise himself as the DARPA chief. Unfortunately, Octopus didn't survive the encounter, thanks to Fox Dot.
You mean you had this plan from the beginning, just to get me to input the detonation code?
Huh? You didn't think you made it this far by yourself, did you?
Who the hell are you?
In any case, the launch preparations are complete. Once the world glimpses the power of this weapon, the White House will have no choice but to surrender the Fox Dye vaccine to me. Their ace in the hole is useless now.
Ace in the hole?
The Pentagon's plan to use you was already successful in the torture room. Snake, you're the only one who doesn't know. Poor fool.
Who are you anyway?
I'll tell you everything you want to know. If you come where I am, that is.
Where are you?
Very close by.
Snake, that's not Master Miller.
Campbell, you're too late.
Master Miller's body was just discovered at his home. He's been dead for at least 3 days. I didn't know because my codec link with Master was cut off. But Mei-Ling said his transmission signal was coming from inside the base.
So who is it?
Snake, you've been talking to...
me, dear brother.
Liquid, how the...
You've served your purpose. You may die now.
Snake, gas! Do something! Snake, call Emmerich. He should be able to break through security.
Snake, that's bulletproof glass. You can't break it with an ordinary weapon.
Can't you open the security lock here?
I'll try. Just hold on for a minute.
And Decoy Octopus.
You don't mean...
That's right.
You were sent here to kill us so they could retrieve Metal Gear undamaged, along with the bodies of the Genome soldiers. From the beginning, the Pentagon was just using you as a vector to spread Fox dye.
Fox dye? It can't be. Are you telling me Naomi was working with the Pentagon?
They thought she was, but it seems that Dr. Naomi Hunter couldn't be controlled so easily.
What?
You've got a spy working in the Pentagon. He reported that Dr. Hunter altered Fox dye's program just before the operation, but no one knows how.
Here so they can find out the answer to that.
No doubt. But I had no idea she was motivated by such petty revenge. We still don't know what changes she made to Fox Dye's program. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I've already added the Fox Dye vaccine to my list of White House demands.
There's a vaccine?
There must be, but that woman's the only one who really knows. Anyway, it might prove to be unnecessary.
Why's that?
You were successful in coming into contact with all of us, so we must have all been exposed to the virus. It's true that the Armstead President and Decoy Octopus were killed by Fox Dye, but Oslon, myself, and you, the carrier, were apparently unaffected.
A bug in the virus's programming.
Could be. In any case, if it doesn't kill you, then I'm not worried either. After all, our genetic code is identical.
So it's true. You and I are...
Yes, twins. But we're not ordinary twins. We're twins linked by cursed genes. Little Fanterine! You're fine. You got all the old man's dominant genes. I got the flawed recessive genes. Everything was done so that you would be the greatest of his children. The only reason I exist is so they could create you.
I was the favorite, huh?
That's right. I'm just the leftovers of what they used to make you. Can you understand what it's like to know that you're garbage since the day you were born? But I'm the father chose.
So that's why you're so obsessed with Big Boss. Some warped kind of love.
Love? It's hate! He always told me I was inferior, and now I'll have my revenge! You should understand me, brother. You killed our father with your own hands! You stole my chance for revenge! Now I'll finish the work that father began. I will surpass him! I will destroy him!
You're just like Naomi.
Well, I'm not like you! Unlike you, I'm proud of the destiny that is encoded into my very genes! Yeah!
Century. It's moving. Rox, stay out of this. What about Naomi? She's hell-bent on taking revenge for you.
Naomi?
You're the only one who can stop her.
I can't.
Why?
Because I'm the one who killed her parents. I was young then, and couldn't bring myself to kill her too. I felt so bad when I decided to take her with me. I raised her like she was my own blood to soothe my guilty conscience. Even now she thinks of me as her brother.
Marks.
On the outside, we might have seemed like a happy brother and sister. Every time I looked at her, I saw her parents' eyes staring back at me. Tell her for me. Tell her that I was the one who did it.
There you are!
We're just about out of time. Here's a final present from Deep Throat. I'll stop it from moving!
Thank you. you into dust.
Just because you've destroyed Metal Gear doesn't mean I'm done fighting.
Fighting? What are you really after?
A world where warriors like us are honored as we once were, as we should be.
That was Big Boss's fantasy.
It was his dying wish. When he was young, during the Cold War, the world needed men like us. We were valued then. We were desired. Things are different now. With all the liars and hypocrites running the world, war isn't what it used to be. We're losing our place in a world that no longer needs us. A world that now spurns our very existence. You should know that as well as I do. After I launch this weapon and get our $1 billion, we'll be able to bring chaos and honor back to this world gone soft. Conflict will breed conflict. New hatred will arise. Then we'll steadily expand our sphere of influence.
But as long as there are people, there will always be war.
But the problem is balance. Father knew what type of a balance was best.
Is that the only reason?
Isn't it reason enough for warriors such as us?
I don't want that kind of world.
Ha! You lie. So why are you here then? Why do you continue to follow your orders while your superiors betray you? Why did you come here? Well, I will tell you then. You enjoy the killing. That's why.
What?
Are you denying it? Haven't you already killed most of my comrades?
That was...
I watched your face when you did it. It was filled with the joy of battle.
You're wrong.
There's a killer inside you. You don't have to deny it. We were created to be that way.
Created?
Les enfants terribles. The Terrible Children. That's what the project was called. It started in the 1970s. Their plan was to artificially create the most powerful soldier possible. The person that they chose as the model was the man known then as the greatest living soldier in the world.
Big Boss.
The father was wounded in combat and already in a coma when they brought him in. So they created us from his cells. With a combination of 20th century analog cloning, and the Super Baby method.
Super Baby method.
They fertilized an egg with one of Father's cells, and then let it divide into 8 clone babies. Then they transferred the clones to someone's uterus, and later intentionally aborted 6 of the fetuses to encourage strong fetal growth. You and I were originally octuplets.
Octuplets?
Yes. The other 6 of our brothers were sacrificed to make us. We were accomplices in murder before the day we were even born. So it was you and I, 2 fertilized eggs with exactly the same DNA. But they weren't finished yet. They used me as a guinea pig to create a phenotype in which all of the dominant genes were expressed to create you. I got all of the recessive genes. You took everything from me before I was even born. But you and I aren't his only children.
What?
The genome soldiers. They too are his progeny, carrying on his genetic legacy. But they're different. Digital. With the completion of the Human Genome Project, the mysteries of humanity were laid bare. Thanks to Father's DNA, they were able to identify more than 60 soldier genes responsible for everything from strategic thinking to the proverbial killer instinct. Those soldier genes were transplanted into the members of the next generation special forces. That's how they became the Genome Soldiers. That's right. The Genome Soldiers that you've been killing are our brothers with the same genes as ours.
The Genome Soldiers?
That's right. They are our brothers, created artificially through the alignment of nucleotides to mimic our father's genes. They too are the product of numerous sacrifices.
Sacrifices?
Human experiments! 1991, the Gulf War. The military secretly injected soldiers with the soldier genes. The Gulf War syndrome that hundreds of thousands of returning soldiers complained about was a side effect of it.
Ha! Everyone knows that the Gulf War syndrome was caused by exposure to depleted uranium used in the anti-tank rounds.
And that was just a cover story issued by the Pentagon. First, they tried to say it was post-traumatic stress disorder, then chemical, biological weapons. The poison gas detection units and the anti-sarin injections, they were all just a cover-up of the secret genetic experiments.
So then, the so-called Gulf War babies that have been reported by Gulf War veterans are...
Yes, they too are our brothers and sisters.
So the Genome Soldiers mean that the experiments were a success?
Success? Don't be a fool! They're a complete failure! We are on the verge of extinction!
What?
Have you ever heard of the asymmetry theory? Nature tends to favor asymmetry. Those species which have gone extinct all show signs of symmetry. The Genome Soldiers suffer from the same problem. Signs of symmetry.
So do I. As do you.
That's right. We are all on the verge of death at the genetic level. We don't know when or what type of disease will occur. That's why we need the old man's genetic information.
You want Big Boss's DNA so you can save your family? It's very touching.
In nature, family members don't mate with each other, and yet they help each other to survive.
Do you know why?
It increases the chance that their genes will be passed on to a new generation. Altruism among blood relatives is a response to natural selection. It's called the selfish gene theory.
You're telling me that your genes are ordering you to save the Genome Soldiers?
You can't fight your genes. It's fate. All living things are born for the sole purpose of passing on their parents' genes. That's why I'll follow what my genes tell me. And then I'm going to go beyond. In order to break the curse of my heritage. And to do that, first, I will kill you. Look behind you!
Meryl! Is she alive?
Not sure. She was alive a few hours ago. Poor girl kept calling your name.
Meryl.
Stupid. Falling in love with a man who doesn't even have a name.
I have a name.
No! We have no past, no future, and even if we did, it wouldn't be truly ours.
You and I are just copies of our father, Big Boss.
Let Meryl go.
As soon as we've finished our business, we're almost out of time.
You're talking about Fox dying.
No. It seems now that the Pentagon knows that Metal Gear is destroyed, they've arrived at a decision. They won't even need a PDA. If you want the details, why don't you ask your precious Colonel Campbell?
Colonel, can you hear me?
Yes, I'm listening.
What is the Pentagon trying to do? Colonel, answer me.
The Secretary of Defense has taken over active control of this operation. He's on his way there by AWACS.
What for?
To bomb the place.
What?
Not only that, B-2 bombers just lifted off from Galena Air Force Base. They're carrying B-6113 surface-piercing tactical nuclear bombs.
What? Metal Gear is destroyed. Tell the Secretary of Defense.
The Secretary of Defense heard that Naomi double-crossed us, and he's worried about Fox Dye. Now that there's no more danger of a nuclear strike from Metal Gear, he's going to do whatever's necessary to cover up the truth of what really happened here.
He's going to drop a nuclear bomb to vaporize all the evidence along with anyone who knows anything.
Don't worry, Snake. I'll stop the nuclear strike.
How?
I may only be a figurehead here, but I'm still officially in command of this mission. If I issue an order to delay the strike, it'll confuse the chain of command and at least buy you some time. It'll give you a chance to escape.
But, Colonel, if you do that...
It's okay, Snake. The truth is, Foxhound was already the subject of an undercover investigation. Meryl was transferred to this base just before the terrorist attack as a way of manipulating me.
Those bastards.
I'm sorry. They forced me to cooperate in exchange for her life. You better get out of there, Snake.
Are you sure? It'll be bad for you.
Don't worry. It's the least I can do for you, after all the lies.
Colonel.
I'm ordering them to cancel the bombing run. After that, there's no turning back.
What? What are you doing?
Snake!
Mei Ling, what happened to the Colonel?
I don't believe it.
What happened?
Snake, the Colonel!
Roy Campbell has been relieved of duty. This is the Secretary of Defense, Jim Houseman.
Put the Colonel back on.
He's been placed under arrest for leaking top-secret information and for the crime of high treason.
Ridiculous.
Yes, he's a ridiculous man. He truly believed that he was in command of this operation.
You bastard.
There won't be a speck of evidence left. I'm sure the President would want the same thing.
President ordered this?
President is a busy man. I have complete authority here.
How do you plan on explaining a nuclear attack on Alaska to the media?
Don't worry. We've prepared a convincing cover story. We'll simply say that the terrorists exploded a nuclear device.
Smart. You'll be murdering everyone here. The scientists, the Genome Army, everyone.
Donald. The DARPA chief is already dead.
So, you didn't mean to kill the DARPA chief after all?
He was my friend.
And you could care less about what happens to everybody else, huh?
Well, if you give me the optic disc, I might consider saving them.
What are you talking about?
Metal Gear's test data. Donald was supposed to bring it back.
I don't have it.
I see. Oh well, that's okay. You two are an embarrassment from the 1970s. Our country's dirty little secret. You can't be allowed to live. Well, the bombs will be dropping soon, and you two have a lot of catching up to do. Farewell.
There's no way out for us. Let's finish this before the airstrike. You stole everything from me. Only your death can satisfy me. Only your death can return to me what is rightly mine. But you make a beautiful sacrifice for our final battle.
a time limit for our final battle. This nuclear module is set to detonate at the precise moment of her death. If you win, you might still be able to save her. You could enjoy one brief moment of love before the end. If you cross this line, you fall. At this height, it will kill even you.
Oh boy, I guess we're considered expendable.
Is there a way out of here?
A way out? Yeah. You can take the loading tunnel to the surface. There's a parking garage right next to you. The tunnel leads from there to the surface.
The door in front?
No. It's a small entrance to the west of that door.
How about the security?
I just unlocked it. Who do you think you're talking to? I'll take care of security along your escape route, too.
What are you going to do?
Me? I'll stay here.
Are you crazy?
I need a little more time to take care of your escape route.
But
unlocking the security doors is difficult work. Only I can do it.
Otacon.
Don't worry. I'm staying here. It's my own decision.
Otacon, this is a hardened shelter, but they're going to use a surface-piercing nuclear bomb. It won't hold.
I'm through regretting the past. Life isn't all about loss, you know. Snake, I'm a complete person now. I found a reason to live.
Good. Don't die on me.
Same to you. Take care of Merrill, okay?
I will.
Okay, I gotta go. I promise I'll do something about your escape route.
Thanks.
Thanks? Well, that sounds nice.
I believe in you.
Thanks, Snake.
Let's get the hell out of here.
What about him? Where's Otacon?
He's fighting right now. With his old self. To be the man he wants to be.
He's fighting for us too?
Yeah. And I don't want it to be in vain.
Me too.
Fire that shot! You ready, buddy? Shoot, Snake!
Are you okay?
Yeah, just a little shook up.
Meryl, can you move?
It's no good. I can't move.
What happened to Liquid?
I can't see him either.
Liquid's dead. Uh-oh.
Snake!
He's dead, that means...
Don't say it, Snake.
What happened to the air raid? No stealth bombers in sight.
Snake, can you hear me?
Colonel,
are you okay?
Colonel, what happened?
The Secretary of Defense has been arrested. Early retirement.
Arrested?
I was able to get into contact with the president. Metal Gear, the training exercise, all of it. It was all the Secretary of Defense acting alone.
Acting alone? What happened to the air raid and the nuclear strike?
The orders were rescinded. The F-117s and the B-2 Spirits have returned to the base. Once again, I have complete authority over this operation.
I see.
Washington isn't stupid enough to use nukes to cover up a few secrets.
I wonder about that.
In any case, the danger's over. Thanks, Snake.
Colonel, you can rest easy. Meryl's fine.
Really? Thanks. Thank you, Snake. Snake, I'm sorry. I kept a lot of things from you.
It's okay, Colonel.
Snake... I'm not a colonel.
Huh. Oh, that's right.
I've got a present for you. There's a snowmobile close to you. Mei Ling saw it on the satellite photos. This time of year, the glaciers are pretty calm. You should be able to ride right out of there. I'll bet the boys at the DIA and the NSA never expect you to come home alive.
Me neither. I better not show my face around here.
No danger of that. You two officially died after your jeep sank into the ocean.
That's not too far from the truth.
Also, there's a helicopter waiting for you on Fox Island.
Dr. Hal Emmerich should be somewhere on the base. I want someone to bring him in.
I understand. Leave it to me.
Okay, Roy. Are you gonna be okay?
Don't worry. I've got an insurance policy. A hard copy of all Mei Ling's data. As long as I've got that, you, me, and Mei Ling will be fine.
The battery on these nanomachines will run out soon. They won't be able to follow us.
I guess we won't meet again.
Don't worry. I'll pay you a visit sometime.
Really? I look forward to that.
Roy, just tell me one thing.
What?
About Fox Dye.
Meryl will be fine. She wasn't included in his programming.
What about me? It killed Liquid.
Naomi said that she wants to talk to you face to face about that.
How is she?
Don't worry. Mei Ling's with her right now. I'm switching over to Naomi.
Snake, it's me.
Naomi.
I heard about my brother.
I'm sorry. But he had one last message he wanted to say to you. He told me to tell you to forget about him and to go on with your own life.
Frankie said that?
Yeah. He also said he'll always love you. Naomi, your brother just saved you, me, and the whole world. He fought with every ounce of strength in his body.
Maybe. Maybe now he's finally found some peace. He wasn't really my brother anymore. Ever since he fought with you in Zanzibar, he's been like a ghost. A ghost looking for a place to die.
Naomi, Liquid died from Fox Dye too. What about me? When am I gonna go?
That's up to you.
What do you mean?
Everybody dies when their time's up.
Yeah, so when's mine up?
It's up to you how you use the time left to you. Live, Snake. It's all I can say to you.
Each person is born with their fate written into their own genetic code. It's unchangeable, immutable. But that's not all there is to life. I finally realized that. I told you before the reason that I was interested in genes and DNA. Because I wanted to know who I was, where I came from. I thought that if I analyzed my DNA, I could find out who I was, who my parents were. And I thought that if I knew that, then I'd know what path I should take in life. But I was wrong. I didn't find anything. I didn't learn anything. Just like with the genome soldiers, you can input all the genetic information, but that doesn't make them into the strongest soldiers. The most we can say about DNA is that it governs a person's potential strengths, potential destiny. You mustn't allow yourself to be chained to fate, to be ruled by your genes. Humans can choose the type of life they want to live. Snake, whether or not you're in the Fox Dye program isn't important. The important thing is that you choose life. And then live. Don't you think, Snake? Don't worry. I'm going to choose life too. Until today, I've always looked for a reason to live. From here on, I'm going to just live. Genes exist to pass down our hopes and dreams for the future through our children. Living is a link to the future. That's how all life works. Loving each other, teaching each other. That's how we can change the world.